As most of you know, Neo sent me a ticket to attend Neo Day 2020 in Chengdu. Aside from the ticket to the event, every cost was borne by me. These impressions are wholly my own. With that out of the way, let's get started. Neo Day started for me with an early morning trip to the hospital to get a COVID test. Even though we've mostly been beyond COVID for a while now, they were taking no chances and required negative COVID tests dated within the past 7 days for anyone attending the event. Ken, one of my YouTube subscribers, a fellow Neo fan, and a future Neo intern, was also in town for Neo Day, so we went together to get our test. We spent most of the day wandering around Chengdu and stressing out as we waited, wondering if we'd get our COVID test results back in time. Luckily, we got our negative results back right at 4 p.m., just as the hospital told us we would. So we had enough time to get to the auditorium and attend Neo Day live and in the flesh. On to Neo Day itself. I have a lot of experience attending corporate events both in China and overseas. Through my previous jobs, I've had the opportunity to go to big-time events like the Sina Weibo Annual Awards, the Cannes Film Festival, Shanghai Fashion Week, and even my previous company's annual party, which was more like a concert with many stars than a work party. As a part of Neo's focus on branding, image, and lifestyle, I honestly expected a lot more from this event. I also can't discount the fact that there is a global pandemic still going on, and that may be why the event was relatively subdued, but I can't help but feel a bit disappointed. I expected that prior to the show, outside the arena, there would be cars on display or activities to participate in. Unfortunately, there wasn't anything like that as far as I could tell. I'll assume that it's because of COVID and give them a pass, but it was still a little bit unfortunate. Inside the arena was a small lifestyle area, but when I passed by, it was cordoned off. I'm not sure if there was a time that we could have got up close and seen the Neo lifestyle products, but when I was there, it wasn't something that we could really take part in, besides look at from a distance. I was also hoping for merchandise booths, so maybe I could grab a t-shirt, but again, there was nothing that I saw. Anyway, that's not really what's important. The Neo Day Show is what you are here to learn about. It started with music from the Neo band and real Neo users. If you saw it, then you know that it was goofy fun and not much more. They sang songs about Neo while the wristbands provided to us lit up in time with the music and the lights. Real Neo owners shared their stories of the pandemic through short films. This was, of course, inevitable. I'm sure that any show anywhere over the next year or so will touch on that pandemic in some way. A bit boring and predictable, but it was expected. Next, the man of the hour came out, Lee Ben. The crowd finally started to get into it at this point. You could really feel the energy shift. The people attending Neo Day are hardcore fans and OG customers. They're the kind of people that buy into this being more than just a car. To them, it's a lifestyle, and everything that Lee Ben said got wild applause, or about as wild as Chinese crowds tend to get, which is not that wild. I took note that when he announced a new eco-friendly clothing line, the crowd let out a noticeably loud cheer. There were only two other louder cheers that I can remember. This shows that Neo fans aren't just fans of the car, but also fans of the brand and the lifestyle and the products that Neo produces. The next big cheer was on the battery news. Solid-state, 150 kilowatt-hour battery with up to 1,000 kilometer range. It really got the crowd to go nuts. These people really don't seem to like charging their car. The version 2.0 swap stations also got a pretty good cheer. Finally, of course, the big reveal, the ET7. The crowd absolutely loved it. When the car came out on stage, the girl behind me literally squealed with delight like it was Justin Timberlake. As soon as Lee Ben said the car was available for pre-order, phones throughout the auditorium went straight to the app, and people were putting down their down payment. These kind of people, with a lot of discretionary income and a love for Neo, are already fully on board. I'm positive that no matter what rolled on stage, they would have been into it. The show capped off with Wang Feng, a Chinese rocker, and to me, a bit of an odd choice. I will come back to this later when I talk about the Neo Day demographics. After the show concluded, I went to the Neo Radio and Neo Life official after party. I should be a little bit delicate on this part because there are very distinct cultural differences between China and the USA, for example. The after party was a very, very Chinese party. There is nothing wrong with that at all, but I think for all the hype online about how Neo isn't just a Chinese company and how they are a brand that really gets it and has potential internationally, some of these small things are still very Chinese and they will need to localize their lifestyle brand approach a little bit when they do head to the West. Of course, these kinds of exclusive parties are not meant for every customer or even for most customers, but it is kind of indicative to me of their brand roots and where they come from. I'm not going to give you a minute-by-minute breakdown of the party, but I will say that for a party in a nightclub in a trendy hotel, there was a great deal of looking at phones. For, not joking you, an hour straight, Neo people were on stage sending digital red envelopes to the Neo After Party group chat. A red envelope is money, if you don't know. They spent an hour straight playing the red envelope game in a nightclub after a huge event. At an after party, ostensibly meant to promote the Neo brand and the Neo lifestyle experience. If the Neo lifestyle experience is looking at your phone and hoping for some lucky money, well, again, I'm not saying it's bad or it's wrong. I'm just saying that this lifestyle experience doesn't really translate. I would bet that when Neo Day or another Neo event happens in a foreign country, or when Neo cars launch in another country sometime in the future, the lifestyle experience will be different and it will be localized to the market. To be honest, it really just stood out to me that these young, hip, wealthy people had nothing better to do than try and get some lucky money for an hour straight. We're talking $15, $20. This is not big money, but that's neither here nor there. But this does lead me directly to the NEO customers' demographics, particularly those at NEO Day and the after party. If you've spent any time in New York or Los Angeles or Sydney or any of the other big global cities during the past decade, you've probably encountered these Chinese kids with their fast cars, trendy Supreme t-shirts, hype beast, those kind of guys. In China, they are called Fuardai, or second generation rich. Now, this is just an assumption on my part. I would have loved to have the opportunity to do a survey about who these guys are and what they do, but I just didn't get the chance. But let's just say that the second generation rich telltale signs were all there. Again, this is not inherently a negative thing, and I'm not saying that they are bad people at all. It felt like to me that a lot of the people at the event, they care more about being seen at the event than actually being at the event, if you know what I mean. I maybe will have more to say about second generation rich and China social media culture in a future video if there is enough interest. So comment if you think you'd like to take a look into that. Looking at these demographics, it also makes me think that the choice of singer for NEO Day was the one big misstep of the day. I wasn't entirely sure who Wang Feng was before the show. Once I knew he was playing, I did look him up, and I did recognize him in some of his songs. I'm not super in the know about all Chinese rock and pop stars, but from my understanding, and asking a few people after the show, he's kind of an old-fashioned, not very cool anymore rocker. For a brand that wants to be young and hip, and chases a younger and cooler market, it did kind of seem like an odd choice to me. It's kind of like if Tesla invited out Jon Bon Jovi to play at their next car reveal. It's not necessarily a bad choice, but dad rock is not really what we think of when we're thinking about the future. Continuing on with this talk about NEO customers and brand loyalty. The people at NEO Day were obviously big fans of NEO, and they believe in the company. However, if you also take a look at the two interviews I did in Shenzhen with real NEO owners, they also seem to feel the same way. Neither of them attended NEO Day, but they're also fully on board with the brand. They not only like their car, but they like the lifestyle that NEO is selling them. In a way, it's a lot like Tesla and Elon Musk fans or Apple and Steve Jobs fans. This kind of loyalty is what every company wants, and it is extremely difficult for most companies to achieve. Ken put it nicely after the show when we were discussing it.
It is one of NEO's philosophy. Don't let your old user doubt.
Yeah. From my observations, it seems like NEO breeds loyalty in a few different ways. First, by offering incentives for early adopters to trade up and to receive discounts. They never want to let their old customers down. They continue to develop brand loyalty through their lifestyle approach with high-end products and clothing options that make their customers feel luxury from their home to their wardrobe to their car. In fact, Lee Bin talked about this at length during his NEO Day presentation. He wants to make the ET7 a luxurious second living room. I saw this loyalty in effect when I was at the airport heading home on Sunday. There were a lot of people still wearing their NEO Day masks. I had time to stop four of them in the airport, two sets of two. One was a young couple, probably late 20s or early 30s from Shenzhen. I asked them if they already pre-ordered the ET7, and they said yes. I also asked if they already had a NEO, and of course they said yes, the ES8. They told me that they pre-ordered the ET7 immediately during the event. I asked them why. The husband said that he liked the speed, it seemed like it's going to be fast, and the woman said that the cameras and the autonomous driving. I then met two young guys, mid-20s, from Shanghai. I asked them the same questions. They said they both had pre-orders already. They said they wanted it because it looked cool. They asked me why I hadn't pre-ordered it yet. I told them that I don't have the money for it. They laughed, and we went on our way. For the NEO faithful, it doesn't seem to be a matter of cost, or even if they should consider to buy it. They're all in with NEO. As I walked through the terminal, I saw more NEO Day masks. I saw people in NEO shirts and even two people with NEO-branded carry-on luggage. This probably shouldn't be unexpected. After the NEO Day event, these people are super fans. It's not like people all across China are wearing NEO clothes, but at the end of the day, this kind of loyalty is what is really needed to make a brand that is more than just a product but a way of life. I'm not saying that NEO stock is going to go to the moon, and I'm definitely not giving you any investing advice, but I do think that the way these customers, from David to Chang Maoge in Shenzhen, to Ken, a future intern at the company, to all the people at NEO Day, these people really love the car, and they love the brand, and they love the way of life. And to me, this can only be a good omen for the company. So that's my roundup of NEO Day. I hope you got something out of it. Please subscribe and like if you can. I would really appreciate it. Take care.